that displays newly created controller from the controller board. Whenever you are creating a controller, if you select on controller, it will show you whatever controller you have created in that number. In our example, we created home controller. So if you click on home controller, it will show you home controller dot CSS. Generally, you can use the following syntax for creating a controller class. Whenever if you are creating a controller, it is like this public class after some name, controller, hyphen controller. That means what? Public class, home controller, controller. So this is a control name. After every controller name ends with a keyword called controller. So it denotes this class is a controller class, home controller, test controller, and controller. Within a bracket, you are going to write a sum of the code. That will be the structure of your controller. So generally, there will be one example. For an is the skeleton code of the controller class, public class test controller, which is extended from controller. And between the codes, you are going to write some code, some action methods. So working with the action methods, how your data will be executed. A controller class contains one or more action methods, also known as controller actions. That means whatever the methods you have created. For example, home is one action, about is one action, get details is one action. So whatever the methods you are creating, each method you are calling it as action methods. So that's why it will contain one or more action methods. You can create only one or a multiple. By default, whenever you have created one controller, by default one method will be displayed, that is the index. Index method will be automatically generated. Okay. And if you want to add extra action method, you can add it. So what is action methods? They are specified. Action methods are responsible for processing the requests that are sent to the controller. Suppose if I am going to send any request, if I enter localhost 5.80.90, so that's it. Whenever if you enter that URL, what it should do, there is a clear result from action method. By default, it will search the whether home controller is there, action method. With home controllers, index method is there, it will execute by default. Suppose if you are writing localhost 8090 slash home slash about, that means there is a request you are sending. You are requesting, I need to execute home controller's action method or home controller's about method, so that as a result it will respond it. So these are action methods are responsible for processing the request and typically returns an action result object that can capture the result of executing a method in real time. Every view method is having a contact action result. Okay. Actually, they have what happens? They are calling a different view pages or HTML pages. Mm-hmm. So that's why by default we are calling it as action result. But till here we will started the views actually. So that's why I use here string only. You can return with a string. So that time the string value will be displayed. Suppose if you are returning an action result, suppose if as a response it has to send the view pages. So that time the return type will be action result. Okay. Sometimes you find action result or sometimes you find view result all are same. Once we start the views, you will get to understand how to use action. Typically return action result. So general process will be like this from the browser, either from Google Chrome or anywhere. If you enter the address http://mdcexample.com/home/index, by default home/index. In a MVC framework, it first comes by a home controller. Okay, it will invoke the home controller's index method. And index method, inside of index method, whatever you wrote, okay, it will be send it as a response. Okay, example, HTTP response. Suppose if you are writing return case.mvc, it will return the string. If you are calling some other view method, so that time it will return the views. Okay. So related to views, you get to understand by next class. We are going to create a view page, so that time you will understand the relationship between controller and a view. So the steps actually same thing, they are showing whatever this image is showing. Actually first step from the web browser, it moves to MVC framework, and second step it is showing invoke. So MVC framework will invoke the home controller's index method. Invoke means calling. Okay. And index method as a response, it returns some values, action result. After this result will be corresponded back to web browser. same thing they are explaining. The browser sends an HTTP request. After that, the MVC framework invokes the controller action methods based on the requested URL. So if you are writing slash home, slash that means homes index method, it will call the methods. The action method executes and returns the action result object, and this object encapsulates the result of action method execution. So actually, after executing your index method, whatever the value it has to return, so it will be returned. If it is an action result, it will return the new page. If it is a string, it will return the string. If it is an int, it returns the int. Okay. Whatever the return type is there, it will return method. The MVC framework converts an action result to HTTP response and sends the response back to the browser. So from the action result, it sends an HTTP response back to the browser. That's actually the procedure, actual procedure of it works. So working with action method, if you are creating an action method, how your method will be there? The rules that you need to consider while creating an action method, if you are including any method within a controller, first thing is they must be declared as a public. So access method, generally in a access specifier means public, private, protected, different types are there. But inside a controller, if you are adding any methods, so it should be public only. If you observe my example, I have added public, all the values should be public. That's the first rule. Second is they cannot be declared as static.
Why it cannot be private if
public means what everybody can access. Yes. Private means what you can access only
within the class.
But controller means what web application means it can be accessed by anywhere.
I see.
So that's why it should be public. They cannot be declared as a static method, because static methods are actually only once it is loaded, it will not be taken back. Instance it will not be created.
So that's
why it should not be static. They cannot have overloaded versions based on a parameter. That means method overloading is one. The same name with a different parameter will be there. Overloaded is not there. Always your structure will be public. Generally, the return type should be action result, but sometimes we can change it, replace it action result with string, int, or anything. After that, the action method, whatever the name is there, and then close the document. Within this, we are going to write a method. So, action method name is a name of the action methods, whatever the name is there, for example, index, order, or anything. So, those methods we are called as action methods. So, actually, all those things you have finished just and before public class home controller, general one example controller. Home controller is the name of the controller, home is the name of the controller, and it extends from controller class. Instead of that, they are adding two methods, public action result x, public action result abort. And inside this code, you can execute, you can insert any of the logic. So that is depending on our task. Suppose in a home, what I need to only I need to call the other method means to try to return names. Okay. Suppose I want to check the login information or I want to validate the content. So that then those in I will write if username is equal to this, password is equal to this, move it to this. If else, if it is wrong. So whatever the logic I need to write, I am going to write in the explanation. We will write the login pages also to the reading later. And I go to this is the structure, basic structure of your method. On the most of the action result, return an action result object, and the action method also returns other types, the string, int, boolean, or hash or other method. So by default, your method name is public action result index. But instead of this action result, this has to return type. Instead of that, you can use the return type as strings, int, and boolean. For example, in a previous example, we used string. Public string index, public string something. Suppose, same thing you can use with public int something. You can use it. So, return type, there is no rules, only it should be action result. You can use the return type as a string, or a int, or a boolean also. Yes, that's the explaining you about. For example, in this example, this this code creates two action methods, name isValue, that returns a boolean value, and contact, that returns a string value. Actually, that is for next example that you are not having. So, actually, if you are having a insert public action method details, you can write a code like isValue username is equal to something else. Okay, username is equal to, suppose I have a string name. So inside a name, I want to insert some values, for example, A, B, C, or anything. Suppose I want to check whether it's a valid number or anything. So that time we are using isValue methods. isValue is a predefined methods. Okay, it will check whether passing the values is following the rules or not. So always if you are calling isValue in a C, it is a C# method actually. So if you are calling isValue, it will return either a true or false. That means if it is a valid one, it will true. It will return a true. If it is a invalid, then it will return false. So if it is having true or false means what I hope that it is, it has to be boolean. So int means number, string means characters. So depending on your data, it may be any of the values you can have. So action result, what is action result there are running? Action result means it's a abstract base class for all the implementing classes that provides different types of result. Actually, it's a one base class and it is for implementing the classes that provides different types of result. Only for giving a result, only for displaying the result, okay, how it should be displayed. And all those they were added in an action result. Action result is a base class. It consists of HTML in combination of server side and a client side script to respond to user actions. Generally, we are using action result as a response if you want to send it back there, some HTML code, okay, or some CSS code. So that time we are using this action. Action result generally will return some web pages. It may be your MVC's view methods or your web forms, .asp, any of the pages or HTML. If you want to, as a response, if you want to send some of the web pages, so that time we are using data that is action result. So in action result, there are actually different types of classes are there. View result returns a view as an HTML document, or partial view result render a partial view. Partial view means what happens? Sometimes we are going to create a view half in one program, half in another file. Partial means half of the code. So suppose if you want to create one view page by merging two pages and all, so that time you are doing partial views. So that you can see when we are creating a view. Okay, in views I will show you how you can create two separate view pages and how you can make it as one page. That is the partial view. Suppose if you are calling a partial views, so that time you can use partial view result. Empty result, suppose your method should not return anything. So empty should be responding, so that time you can use empty result. A redirect result, it redirects a response to another action. Suppose if you are calling an index method, okay, so that time instead of that, when you call an index method, it should be redirected to another method. By using a, if you call index method, I want to call about method, for example. So what we will do, inside a public string index, it will do it, redirect to home controller's about method. So that time what happens? Even though if you call the index method, it will navigate into another method, about methods. Suppose from one method, if you want to call another method, so that time you are using redirect result. So you can also redirect a response to another action method. So from one method, you are going to navigate into another one. JSON result, it returns the result as a JSON, also known as JavaScript object notations. JSON is the open standard format to store and exchange test information. JSON is mainly for data connections and all. If you want to send some JSON files as a response and all, so that's why we are doing JSON. So these are the different methods or different classes which is present in action result class. Okay, these are theory parts, these are not needed. They are showing what is the action classes, so how the action result is created. In a real classes, we are not when we are writing these partial view result, empty result, these things we are not using much. Directly we are using action result. If you are using action result, all these classes are included inside the classes. Next is invoking action method. Invoking means calling the action. Suppose I want to call one particular methods. Okay, how to call? So that's what they explained. This one also I have shown previously. So in an ASP.NET MVC application, you can create multiple action methods in a controller. That means in a one controller, you can create multiple methods. So for example, previous example, you created home, above, details, private. Okay. You can invoke an action method by specifying a URL in the web browser containing the name of the controller and action methods too. Suppose you want to execute a particular method. So that time you can call it by specifying the URL in the web browser, containing the name of the controller and an action method, which will be there, STDB or any of the name. Domain name is whatever the name you have, www.abc.com, that's actually domain. But if you are running from Visual Studio directly, if you use localhost, 8090, something, that will be the domain now. After that, the controller name, home, or any other controller name, whatever you have given, slash action method. If you want to call the method, home slash index, home slash above. So this is how to invoke the, and how to call the action methods. This one also we will discuss. For example, they were given one example. Consider the following URL, http://mvcexample.com/home/registration. That means in this mvcexample.com, call the home controller's registration methods. So it searches the home controller class, and it searches the registration action method in a home controller class. Inside a home controller, it will search for this method and it executes a registration method. It will execute this method, and after executing this, whatever the response is going to send, the result. This is how your method will execute. So just I'm recalling those things. I explained all these things in examples. So just they are showing the same thing in a book also. Invoking, next they are referring to passing parameter. Passing parameters, last time I have some string name, how to pass the parameter. So you can use /home/index?name is equal to something else. You can access. So same thing they are referring to. How to pass the parameter, this one also have shown. Suppose in an action method, suppose you want to pass some parameters, so how to pass the parameters. Sometimes you may need to provide inputs other than the web page name when requesting the directory. Suppose if I want to call for some method, I need to add some of the methods. So how to pass it? For example, www.mvcexample.com/product/details. :id=0. What is that? So this is a controller name, student. After the previous is a method name, after we need to pass a parameter. So it is a parameter for details method. Basically, you are invoke the details action method of student controller class, and the URL also contains ID parameter with the value 00. Details action method must accept an ID parameter of type string in order to return student that was based on the ID. Same thing as I told. This one also I have shown the example. Whenever it is passing a parameter, if you have a method like this, public action is a details, string ID, if you want to call the method, for that time you should write like this, :details?? Of the parameter, ID is equal to part of the name. Next, the routing request. The routing means, suppose if you want to configure whenever you start the by default, which method has to execute. in a particular method. So that is how we can monitor. This one I have explained. Let me suppose I want to change the default method. I want to control it. From where I can change? I can change it from rootconfig.cs. When there is a rootconfig, there is home is it controller is equal to home, and then method is equal to certificate. So by default it will be home index. Suppose by default whenever you are running, it should execute home. About method means there in action is that I need to modify the method.
That is why the URL now,
yes, URL,
you are calling URL, this method.
There actually two options are there. URL option can monitor and configuration option.
Yes.
So that's why that's
it's by the routing.
Yes.
Routing.
Okay. At the time of creating a front-end application, the application can register multiple routing patterns also. We can, for example, sometimes if I want to configure it like as a home, I could find a local/slash home, which pay as possible. Local/slash account, which pay as possible. That multiple also I can configure it there. So, root tables provide the information on how rooting engine process requests that contains those patterns. So, root engine is a main component, it is going to execute actually, it is going to root it. Okay. So, how it will take from the root configuration? You have modified, you have configured it. So from the root configuration path, it will take the path and it will route it to that particular information. So for example, they are showing the default root we can find it from here. And in this application requires a root to handle the user request. When you create case.mvc applications, the root is automatically configured to rootconfig.cs file. You will find this roots.maproot. Name by default it will show you default and URL will be controller/action/ID. It should be in this format. Okay. And by default it can be dictated controller name is home, action method is index, ID is URL parameter dot option. That means initially you will make parameter is optional. Suppose it should be always should be available. For example, home action, and after the install option, you can set it. Okay, it should be fixed, or it should be entered, and it should be requirement. So then, whenever if you're calling controller action method, this one ID also monitor. Okay. So here they made it by default is optional. That means if you can pass the parameter also not a problem. If you're not calling also, it's not a problem. If your method includes the parameter, then you should. Okay. So by using here, you can modify the routing.
Pwede i-change ang order na talagang controller action ID. Yung pwede controller ID action.
Pwede rin ah. Basta nasa same assembly lang minsan.
Pero para matawagan na ID, kailangan mo yung, ano, yung action method. Or straight ka na pwede sa ano. Kasi under lang naman siya sa controller ko. Hindi alam mo.
Hindi pa ako nakapagpasa siya.
Application file includes only these type proofs.maproot and default. Sometimes you will observe more than one maproot will be there. For example, it will be like this. Here, if you observe here, actually proofs.maproot it starts here and it ends here. But you can observe here proofs.maproot two sets are there. One set includes name is general, URL is controller/action. Default is controller/index. Okay. Similarly, one more root, proofs.maproot, for that they were given. Name is manager, URL is manager/action. Default is new controller manager action rows. Okay. So, what happens? Sometimes we are going to write it like this, controller/action. So, what it means? How it will decide which method has to execute? Suppose if you are going to register, if you are requesting for any page,
you're not a member of the
page. So that time you are entering www.tdc.com. So that time you check general. Okay, it lets you go to next. Suppose if whenever you are entering directly, you will enter the slash type www.tdc.com/manager. If you enter /manager, then automatically it will check the URL. Example, if the URL is starting from manager, then it will call manager's index browse method. If for another one by default, if you are not entering manager, then it will call home index method. So like that you can create multiple routing mapping also in root computer CSS files.
VIP.
Nice.
Read the last two parts.
Okay.
This code contains two placeholder and set the default value of the control parameters to home and the action parameter to index.
Okay.
So that is first one. Okay.
And the index. Okay.
So by default home and index, and there will be general. Okay. If you enter, you are with the controller action data. Home/something else.
Yep.
Okay. For the second one, second root contains a literal manager. You are manually, if you observe the URL here. Okay.
So
the first one, you are specifying controller/action. That means any controller and any action method, if you enter it, by default it should call the home action method, home index method. Suppose in a URL, when you are calling www.gate.abc, that is URL only if you are specifying manager as a content. Okay? Suppose if you are writing localhost/8090/manager, that means what? Manager is a controller. So if it finds manager in a URL,
it will execute this.
It will find manager action. Then it will directly execute manager's browse method.
Okay, okay.
So second, that contains a little manager and a placeholder and set the default value of the control parameter to manager